other ways around this, and therefore power is directly relevant and important to us. Agricultural productivity must be scaled up to ensure food security for our people and provide the input for agro-processing that will plug us into global agricultural value chains. Manufacturing is central to job creation, technology transfer, new ideas and innovation. Given that the economy is a system, the economy as a whole is a system that is all connected, what the MITI plan seeks to do is to establish synergy and connectivity across different sectors on a foundation of an attractive business environment. It is in this context of both challenge and opportunity that this 8th session of the Nigerian Council on Industry, Trade and Investment is meeting. Therefore, it is not and it cannot be business as usual. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, there is no better time than now to realign our policies and programs to deliver the change we all desire. As Chairman of the Council, I urge you to critically examine all the issues that have been placed on the table. Nigeria has been handed a historic opportunity to rebalance, reset, and diversify the economy, and by so doing, set the country on the path of structural transformation and sustainable development. The questions that we ask over the next few days are as valuable as the answers we propose. One question that we should concern ourselves with is how can the state and federal government synergize to create an enabling business environment? For instance, in access to land and property rights, processing of various permits, registration of businesses, internet connectivity for economic modernization, and so on. With the collapse of commodity prices, how would manufacturers and players in the agricultural sector in the states exploit their comparative advantage to export to other markets such as ECOWAS, the large African market, and other preferential markets like those offered by the African Growth and Opportunity Act, AGOA? As the highest policy advisory body in the industry, trade and investment sector, a lot is expected from this 8th Council at a time such as this. The decisions and recommendations that we make at this forum will go a long way in providing useful inputs and solutions to the many challenges facing the industry, trade and investment sectors. As Chairman of the Council, I look forward to your ideas and constructive recommendations as we articulate and implement a bold plan for diversification and growth. Let me therefore charge us all to remain focused and to participate actively in our deliberations to ensure that we achieve our set goals. In closing, I'd like to pay tribute to all the people who helped to put this program together. You have worked very hard indeed to prepare us for this 8th National Council. In particular, I commend the excellent work done between the Ogun State Government officials and members of the Federal Ministry of Industry, Trade and Investment in putting this together. I want to thank you very much, and I know that the level of cooperation, if we work together as a government that way, at the federal, state and local government levels, there is yet hope for Nigeria. Thank you very much. Finally, I thank again our special guest of honor, His Excellency the Vice President, and our most hospitable and generous host, His Excellency Senator Ibukunle Amosu. Thank you very much, sir. God bless you all. Thank you.
Once again, can we appreciate the Honorable Minister for that opening remarks? That was very, very comprehensive. He actually received his inspiration because of his Adire attire. At this point, Your Excellencies, may I now invite to give us a goodwill message on behalf of the upper and the lower legislative arm, a distinguished Senator Sam Egbo, the Chairman, Senate Committee on Industry.
Your Excellency, the Vice President of this great country, Professor Yemi Osibanjo, GCON. The Executive Governor of Ogun State, and my good brother, Senator Ibikunle Amosun, CON. The former president of this country and the architect of modern Nigeria, my own boss, Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, GCON. The minister.
Just 2 minutes.
Okay.
Just two minutes.
The Honorable Minister of Industry, Trade and Investment, Okechukwu Enelama, and the Honorable Minister of State, Hajia Aisha Abubakar, my colleagues at the National Assembly, especially the chairman of the relevant committees, our royal fathers, your royal highnesses, heads of government agencies and captains of industry, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. The focus of this meeting, diversification of the Nigerian economy from over-dependence on oil exports, is very apt. This is because the current economic challenges we are facing as a nation is caused largely by decades of operating a mono economy anchored on crude oil revenue, which led to a regrettable neglect of enormous potentials in other sectors and gross underdevelopment of our agricultural and manufacturing sector. With the present drastic fall in the price of crude oil and the unfortunate free fall of the value of Naira against the dollar, we must practically begin to diversify our economy to enhance sustainable economic growth and development. To effectively diversify our economy, we must stabilize the power sector, focus on agriculture, and prioritize the manufacturing and industrial sector. We must begin to produce what we consume and consume what we produce. No doubt, it is the role of the legislature to enact the relevant laws that will create favorable legal framework to enhance economic diversification and economic recovery. It is in recognition of this responsibility that we have taken various legislative steps to drive the much needed diversification. The National Assembly passed a resolution directing the National Electric Regulatory Commission, NERC, to live up to its responsibility by addressing the numerous challenges that manufacturers and other electricity consumers are facing as a result of the unfair trade practices of electricity distribution companies in Nigeria. A whole lot of more still need to be done, and urgently too, including exploring other resources of power like solar. This is because until we stabilize the power sector, our quest for diversification and sustainable economic development may remain a dream. In order to enhance diversification, the warehouse receipt bill is currently undergoing the legislative process at both houses. The bill seeks to establish the Nigerian Independent Warehouse Regulatory Agency to regulate the operations of licensed warehouses and to provide a regulatory framework for trading in warehouse receipts to enable depositors to store agricultural or other commodities in commercial warehouses and upon issue of a negotiable warehouse received by the warehouse, be able to use it as collateral to obtain finance from financial institutions and to make warehouse receipts valid negotiable instruments. When passed into law, it will provide farmers with an instrument that will allow them to extend the sales of period of perishable products beyond the harvest season. Farmers can deliver their products to an accredited warehouse and obtain a warehouse receipt that can be used as collateral for short-term borrowing. Secure warehouse receipts will also enable owners of inventories to borrow both locally and abroad and at lower interest rates. This bill will fast-track the diversification of our economy and has successfully passed, that has, this bill has successfully